Ya no estás más a mi lado, corazón. El alma solo tengo soledad. Y si ya no puedo verte, porque Dios me hizo quererte para hacerme sufrir más. Siempre fuiste la razón de mi existir. Adorarte para mí fue religión. Brazos encontrar el amor que me brindaba, el calor de tu pasión es la historia de un amor como no hay otro igual, que me hizo comprender todo el bien y todo el mal, que le dio luz a mi vida.
Ay, ya, Isma, ya, descansa. You do mostly fine. I'm not gonna fight.
I saw you.
Yeah, who cares
for
them? I don't
want to now.
Ya, Isma, suéltalo, por favor.
Ya no estás más a mi lado, corazón. El alma solo tengo soledad. Y si ya no puedo verte, porque Dios me hizo quererte para hacerme sufrir más.
Como si fuera esta noche la última vez.
My grandpa, Ismael de Jesus, was born in Guayama, Puerto Rico, and moved to New York City with his family by the age of 12. He was the second oldest of three children, being raised by his mother. My grandma, Antonia Cora, was also born in Puerto Rico. Her real mother was from Spain, and her father was a Black Puerto Rican traveling musician. Grandma was fostered by her mother's cousin after the death of her father. Soon after, her name was legally changed to Carmen, but she remained with the nickname Tony. She also migrated to New York City with her foster mother by the age of 14. Grandma and Grandpa met in their early teens living in the same neighborhood of Bushwick, Brooklyn. They began dating and visiting Manhattan every weekend to party, specifically to Harlem. Grandpa wasn't a drinker or smoker until he met Grandma. She turned him out as she loved the party life.
Ahí hay grandma para rato. They're so cute.
Ahí, déjale ahí un poquito de ahí, ahí.
Ajá, grandma.
By this time, Grandma had already dropped out of high school to work as a seamstress, while Grandpa's trade was auto mechanics. They did not marry until Grandpa was drafted into the Korean War. Grandma never wanted to marry Grandpa because she knew him to be unfaithful. However, in order for Grandma to receive his military paychecks and any benefits in case something would happen to him, they had to be married. So February 25th, 1951, they were married before he left to the military. They already had three kids at this point. By 1956, three more kids were produced, totaling six children together. Ismael Jr., known as Papo, Gregory, known as Archie, Dora, known as Dori, Edwin, known as Chino, Richard, known as Ricky, and Yvette, known as Evie. Grandpa also had three other children outside of their marriage. One daughter before he was married, and Hector and Nereida from a long-time affair with another woman. In the early years, Grandpa owned a gas station in Brooklyn that had a mechanic shop. He lost the gas station to the mob. They lived in New York from the 1930s until 1974, when they decided to move to Miami. The house they were renting in New York was sold to the state to build a new shopping center. Not to mention, the recent death of their son, Archie, was weighing on them. Grandpa's sister-in-law, Anna, and his youngest daughter, Evie, were already living in the Sunshine State. They took a trip to see if they would like it. They did, and returned with the idea to buy a house there, which they did. They moved into their new home at 84 Northwest 26th Street in Wynwood area of Miami, Florida. Grandma got a job at a local factory as a seamstress at first, and then was promoted to shipping and receiving of the merchandise. She worked for Doris of Miami for over 20 years. Meanwhile, Grandpa put his auto mechanic skills to use, fixing cars in the driveway of their home to make a living. The house in Miami became party central, just like their home in New York. They loved to play music, dance, and drink with friends. They constantly had people over on the weekends and had visitors from New York all the time. They would attend dance concerts when big name Spanish bands would tour in Miami. It was a time of dinner and dancing. Grandma would sew her own outfits together and look smoking hot. The Miami home became a safe haven for their family and a vacation place for their 17 grandchildren who lived in Miami and other states. They raised two grandchildren in this house, Gregory Jr., known as Archie, and Haiti. Haiti was the daughter of their youngest child, Evie. Archie was their firstborn grandchild from their son who passed away. His son was his namesake. Decade after decade, their love and strengths were tested. They endured the pain of losing both of their daughters, Dori and Evie, on different occasions. Continuously growing generation after generation, they remained the pillars for the De Jesus name, always opening their doors to troubled family members or anyone seeking the love within a family environment. Survivors and socializers, well into their 80s in age, with more than 67 years of marriage, 6 children, 17 grandchildren, 54 great-grandchildren, and 25 great-great-grandchildren. La Familia de Jesus and Grandma's House are historical in their own right for the Puerto Rican community in Wynwood, Miami, Florida. A large, beautiful family with a legacy built by the love shared between my grandma and grandpa, Ismael and Carmen de Jesus.
Canción que lleva alma, corazón y vida, estas tres cositas nada más te doy. Porque no tengo fortuna, estas tres cosas te ofrezco, alma, corazón y vida y nada más. Alma para conquistarte, corazón para quererte y vida para vivirla junto a ti.
alma para conquistarte, corazón para quererte y vida para vivirla junto a ti.
Tus ojos y estar junto a ti.
Piensa que tal vez mañana.